हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माई सेल्फ प्रोफेसर एन बी भोकनर फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एग्रीकल्चरल माइक्रोबायोलॉजी एंड प्लांट पैथोलॉजी, करंटली वर्किंग इन केकेवा कॉलेज ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर नासिक. वेलकम बैक. ड्यूरिंग लास्ट लेक्चर वी स्टडीड मेथड्स ऑफ डायग्नोसिस. नाउ यू मस्ट बी ईगर टू नो अबाउट डिटेक्शन मेथड्स ऑफ प्लांट डिसीजेस. हियर इज द लिस्ट ऑफ मेथड्स ऑफ डिटेक्शन. फर्स्ट दैट इज इनक्यूबेशन मेथड, then without incubation method, examination of seed washing, then agar plate method, then various lab test, host pathogenicity test, biochemical test and serological test. Let's see in detail one by one. First one, that is examination of seeds without incubation. Here seed sample is examined or checked by naked eye or under microscope for presence of discoloration, fungal fructification or structure like sclerotia, gall, acervulae, pycnidia, bacterial ooze, etc. For example, black point of wheat or ergot fungi, etc. Next, examination of seed washing. Here, the seed sample is immersed or soaked in water so that it will release some fungal spores or the symptoms may become visible, which are attached to the seed. And this method, it is applicable for obligate pathogens like downy mildew, which require a living host. In this case, seed sample, these are kept in sterilized water, then these are kept on mechanical shaker and washing is collected. Then afterwards, washing is centrifuged at 2000 to 3000 RPM. And then lactophenol is added to the sediment. Sediment that is the basal portion, and supernatant that is upper layer is removed, and the further sediment is observed under microscope. Third method, incubation method. In that first one, standard blotter method. It is very convenient and effective amongst all the methods. It was first proposed by scientist Doyer. As per ISTA standards, usually 400 seeds are incubated. In this method, in petri plates, sterilized petri plates, 2 to 3 layers of moist sterilized blotters are used, and on that blotters seeds are placed at equidistance, and the number may vary from 10 to 100 depending upon the seed size. These are incubated for around 7 days under 12 hours light and 12 hours darkness at normal temperature. Here is the sample. First one, that is the standard blotter test. Then second is the result. Then 2,4-D blotter method, which is also called as modified blotter method. In this case, for easy observation of seed samples, the blotters, these are dipped in the 2,4-D solution having concentration that is 200 ppm. Due to this, seeds get killed and pathogen easily attack on it and grow on it. Next, deep freezing blotter method. This was proposed by Limonard, and it is again modification of standard blotter method. In this case, same procedure is done as in blotter method, sowing method. But difference is that for 1 to 2 days, these plates or seeds are incubated at normal room temperature and further subjected to minus 20 degrees Celsius on the third day. And after 12 hours, these are again re-exposed to the normal room temperature. Now the dead seeds, they act as a source of nutrients for the fungi. Next is the agar plate method. In this method, seeds are placed in petri dishes on the media containing agar, for example PDA. Then before plating, pre-treatment to seeds is given using surface disinfectant, that is sodium hypochlorite or mercuric chloride. and these are incubated under standard temperature. After incubation, colony characters are recorded. Next, visual separation of infected seed. There are some diseased seeds which do not show external symptoms, for example Pseudomonas spatiolicola. Then these seeds are exposed to the UV radiation and which revealed the fluorescence. The seeds which show the bright bluish white fluorescence, these are infected with the bacteria, and they showed the hollow blight symptoms on the infected plants. Next, that is water agar plate method. It is used for detection of black rot of crucifer caused by bacteria. In this case, the seeds first soaked in the antibiotic solution, that is oreofungin, around 200 ppm concentration. After soaking, excess solution is drained off, then seeds are placed on nutrient agar media, then incubated at 20 degrees Celsius in darkness, and after 12 days records or observations are maintained. Then the deceased seedlings which show the delayed germination and stunted growth, in this case the hypocotyl and cotyledons, they become yellowish seedlings, collapse on the agar surface, and from the infected plant parts the yellowish bacterial ooze can be seen under the microscope. Next is the grow out, or which is also called as growing on test. These are performed in a greenhouse test, that is in controlled environment, where the pathogen symptoms are observed from seed to seedling stage. For example, in case of Pseudomonas syringae pathover fasciolicola, here this test gives the indication of transmission of external and internal seed inoculum, but this test are time consuming and require a very large space for testing. Next, lab test, which include seed extraction, then isolation into culture, then identification. Then next one, that is host pathogenicity test. Here the pure culture of the bacteria or the seed extract is inoculated into the host plant or seeds to test the pathogenicity of the bacteria, that is disease causing ability. Then these plants are inoculated by a number of different methods. First one, that is an injection, then second one, that is a leaf abrasion, and third one, that is a vacuum infiltration. Injection, in this case the pure culture is taken and injected into the leaf. Then in case of leaf abrasion, with the help of carborundum powder, a wound is created, and then spraying of particular culture is done. Growing on test, this is used for mainly seed borne viruses, for example lettuce mosaic virus, bean common mosaic virus, etc. Then infectivity test. For infectivity test, the local lesion host or indicator host is used. In this case, indicator host, it is inoculated with the extract of infected seed sample and observed for the symptom development. Next, biochemical method. Here the virus infection, it can be detected by staining with the 1% floxin solution. Due to this, it causes biochemical and physiological changes in the host tissues. Then serological methods, for example MEAN, that is ELISA, it is a very sensitive test for seed-borne viral diseases. It stands for enzyme-linked immunosorbent assay, and most widely used in it, that is DAS ELISA, double antibody sandwich ELISA. The main principle to detect the binding of antibody to antigen, that is the Key-and-Lock principle. Then next one, that is remote sensing. Without touching any object, the remote sensing is carried out. That is, disease detection is done by thermography using near infrared wavelengths. Then next one, that is a flow cytometry. In this, sample containing cells is suspended in a fluid and injected into the instrument. Here, detection of this pathological cells or pathogen cells is done, or population of cells is counted. So we studied different methods of detection of plant diseases, like incubation method, without incubation method, seed washing, blotter methods, agar plate method, host pathogenicity test, etc. Thanks for patient listening. See you in the next lecture. Stay home, stay safe.